So hello guys, welcome to the web technology lab videos. So today we will discuss the remaining part of assignment number 4. So in first 3 videos we have created database file, database connection file, then registration page, then login page. Now we'll go further. We'll create welcome.php file, we'll create logout.php file and get data.php file. Okay, so here we are going to implement AJAX, that is asynchronous JavaScript and XML. So first we'll use welcome.php. So first I'll write PHP tag. So after that I'll do one thing. I'll start my session here, session_start. Okay, use session_start function. Then after that I will check whether my session has been set or not. So I'll call isSet function. Inside this I will check my session with the help of session. Okay, so this is global variable that I can use. Okay, so this, with the help of this global variable, I will access the value. Okay, that is the username. Okay, so this session already created in login.php file. So here I am checking just whether it is not it is set or not set. So it is not. If it is not set, then it will do one thing, that is it will go to the location. Okay, which location? That is your login.php. okay, so it will transfer the control to the login.php. it will again ask for you to log in the system. Okay, then to exit. So this is about your session management for welcome.php that will make our welcome.php page secure. Now after this we'll start HTML coding. Okay, so here I'll write welcome page in title. Then after this we'll type, okay, I'll type here h3, I'll use heading 3, and here I will write welcome. Okay, now what I want to do, I want to show the username here. Okay, after this welcome I will show the username. So I have to use here again PHP code. I'll write PHP tag here. Okay, and here I will display with the help of echo, then I will print my session variable. Okay, so I'll print my session variable here. So I will access session in bracket username. Okay, so this will print, this will have the value that is already stored in login.php file. So that value will be accessed here. Okay, and that will be printed here. Okay, username value. Now after this we'll put one horizontal line. Okay, then we'll do one thing, that is we'll print something here. Okay, so I want to do one thing here, that is I want to let a user to select the username. Okay, select the username of student. Okay, so I'll write this thing here. Okay, so I'll ask them to select the username of student, the name of student, so that it will display the whole information of that student which is stored in database on the same page. So there we are going to use AJAX. Okay, later on I'm going to explain that. So right now we'll display select name of student, and then I'll use form tag. So in this form tag I'll write select, I'll use select box. Okay, in select I'll use options. Okay, so first option I will use, that is my name. Okay, so value I will set here. Okay, so this value I want to pass to the next page, so that for that purpose we are using here value attribute and its value here. Okay, so then next option I will use, I'll use next name. Suppose I use other name of student, and I will provide other value here. Okay, then the third option I will use, and then I will again use the third name of student and its value an option tag. Okay, so here I did it, but before this we'll start with the empty select student. Okay, so this I'll display here. So I'll write here value blank. Okay, so this one option I will add here, that is select student. Now after this I want to do one thing, that is I want to add an event on change here. Why on change? Because whenever I choose any option, okay, like let's consider I choose this option where student name is Santosh, so that time it should transfer, so this page should transfer this value to the next page. Okay, and how it should transfer the value, it should transfer this value through a JavaScript code. So I am going to define a JavaScript code here, and there I will define a function. So that function I want to call here. Okay, so whenever I choose any of the option, that time this on change event is occurring. So because of that we are using on change event handler here. Okay, so this will have a function call here. So I'll give the name of that function here. So show student, this function name I will function I will call here. Now after this I'll do one thing, that is I'll put one button here. Okay, so I'll again write, okay, so again I will write a form tag here. Okay, so let's consider we'll do another form tag here. Okay, so I'll use another form tag, and this form tag I'll write input, okay, type equal to submit, name is equal to SBT, value is equal to log out. So I'll create a logout button here, and in this form tag I will put action is equal to log out dot php. So this page I'm going to create, logout dot php, where it will have the code of logout operation. So this I will do here. Now this show student function we have to define in JavaScript. Now I will go in head tag. In head tag here I will use script tag, and inside this script tag I'll define my function, that is function show student. In bracket I will pass a variable, a parameter, that is str. So this will hold the data that I want to transfer to the next page. Okay, so then here I will define a variable xhttp. Now here we are doing AJAX, that is asynchronous JavaScript and XML. Here what AJAX is doing, AJAX is enabling us to load the data without refreshing the page. Okay, that is the use of AJAX. So whenever we don't want to refresh our page and we want to retrieve the data from the server, that time we can use AJAX. So here we are going to use AJAX. So for that purpose, first variable that is required, xhttp. So this is user defined variable. You can use other variables also. You can define other variables also. So after that I will check whether the input, that is str, is blank or not. If it is blank, then I will do one thing, that is I will print. Okay, so I'll do one thing, get element by id. okay, so I'll call here one of the function, that is get element by id, and in this function I want to pass the id where I want to print, id of the block where I want to print my output. Now see here, after this button, okay, so after this form I will create one. Okay, I will put br tag. Okay, I'll put another br tag, and inside this I will put one division tag, and I will give the id, that is SHW. Okay, so this ID I will provide here to this block. So this is one of the block I have created here. This is empty block, this is empty element where I want to print my output, which is getting from the server. Okay, so here in this if block I will do one thing, that is I will use that name here, ID, that is ID of the block SHW, and then I will write it into double quote. Then I will call inner, I will use inner HTML property. Okay, so which will help me to print the data. Okay, which will help me to print the response on my that given block. Okay, so it will print blank because the string is blank, and then I'll write return. Okay, after this I'll do one thing, that is I will again use the XHTTP variable, and now this time I'm going to create an object of XML HTTP request. Okay, so here I will create XML HTTP request object with the help of new XML HTTP request. Then with the help of XHTTP I will open, sorry, with the help of XHTTP reference I will open the file. Okay, so which file I want to open? So this data I'm going to send on the next PHP file, so I want to open the next PHP file which will handle my data, which is sent by this form, this page. So here I will use right for the get method that I'm going to use. Okay, then the file name where I want to transfer the data, the file name I will provide here. I'll use here URL forwarding. So here I will use the another variable, that is name equal to plus str, okay, and then comma true. So your open function is having three parameters. First is request method, HTTP request method, that is get I'm using here by default. I'm already using get here. So then where to send your, where do you want to send your data? Okay, so the data I'm sending on my getData.php file. Through which variable I'm going to send this name variable I will use, through which variable I will assign this str value to that variable. Okay, and then I will use third parameter, that is true. So here I want a synchronous operation, so that is I'm setting true. If we I set false, it will do synchronous operation. Okay, so now after this I'll use again HTTP and I will call send method, which will do the sending operation here. Okay, then after this, then again I want to define a block. I'll use XHTTP dot on ready state change. This is one of the property that I want to use. Okay, so that property I will use here. Why to use that property? Because I want to check whether my operation is ready or not. Okay, so whether my process is in ready state or not. So here that on ready state change is used, so it will define a function which will operate when your state changes. Okay, now in this function, okay, so I'll do here semicolon, I will write. So here I'll write, again I will write if statement. Okay, so if condition I will write here. In this if condition I will check, this, I will use this pointer which will access the current value. Okay, equal to equal to 4, here I will use the 4 value. Ready state equal to equal to 4 represents your response is ready, your request response is ready, and it has been completed successfully. That is the meaning of 4 here. Okay, so after that, and I will use this dot status. Status is equal to equal to 200. 200 says okay. So if everything is fine, that time it will return ready state equal to 4, and it will return status that is okay, 200. Okay, and then after this we'll do one thing. If everything is getting right on place on time, that time we'll do one thing, that is we'll print therefore document dot get element by id. I will call this function and I will access the id of my block where I want to print my output. So that id I will use here, that is ssw. Then dot inner html is equal to print on the html in the html output. I'll write this dot response text. Okay, so response text will hold your response which is getting from the other page. Okay, so this I have done here. Now after this the script has been completed. Now the next page. Okay, but before this we'll just go to in this page again. Okay, so the str is ready here. Just one thing that we have missed here, that is in show student we are doing here what? In show student we are passing a parameter, that is str, but here we are not passing any parameter. So here we have to pass the parameter, because without that we cannot pass the value to the next function. So here I will use this dot value so that it will access the current values, current option values. So these values are already defined here. Okay, so these values will be, whenever this option is selected, these values will be accessed here with the help of this pointer. Okay, now this we have done here. Now we'll go for next page, that is get data dot php. So in this page I will go for again php tag. Okay, so here in php tag, first of all we'll do one thing, that is we'll start the session, but before that we'll connect with the database with the help of require underscore once. Okay, so this I will use here, and with the help of this we'll connect with the db connect connect.php file. Okay, then we'll start the session because we want to use session variable here, that is already set in login.php. So after this again I will check whether my session is connected or not, is set in bucket dollar underscore session, then username. Okay, so if it is not set, then it is going to transfer the control to the login.php file. Okay, login.php, then exit. Okay, so this will happen there. Now after this we'll take the value which is sent by the welcome.php here. So now welcome.php has sent this name value. So this name variable is sending the value to the this page get data.php. So we'll access that here. So again I will use dollar name is equal to dollar underscore request. This function you want to use, you have to use here. So dollar request in bracket use the name of that variable. Okay, that is name. Okay, so then we have to define a query, SQL query here. Okay, so that query we will define here. With the help of that query we are going to transfer, we are going to process the value. So we'll see here. Okay, so dollar SQL equal to, okay, so we'll that thing here, dollar SQL equal to select star from student is my table name, where I will check what I will check here, dollar where username is equal to, in single quote I will use this dollar name. Okay, so I will compare with the username here. Okay, now I want to execute this query, so I'll write again another variable, that is the result variable, and in this variable I will call mysqli underscore query. This function I will call, and here I will write my connect database connection variable $con that is already in dbconnect.php. Then $sql, this I will use because it is holding my query. Now after this I will check one condition, that is if I'll check mysqli underscore num underscore rows, I'll return the number of rows here. So which rows I want to return here. Okay, so after this it is going to return error. Okay, after this query, that is select part from student where username equal to dollar name, so it is going to return some number of rows, that is if data found it will return one row, if doesn't found it will return zero. So here I'll write this variable name, that is dollar result, which is holding the result, okay, which is holding the value. Okay, so if it is greater than zero, then I'll do one thing, I'll print. Okay, so I'll print here, then pop echo, I'll print my table. Okay, I'll print my table here with the pop table tag. I can do that here. So echo table tag I will use, then border I will use here, border equal to one. I'll use single quote here. So remember, whenever you are going to use quotes inside quote, so if you have double quotes outside or inside statements or for inside values, you should use single quote, but don't use double quotes multiple times here. If you are having for outer block, if you are having double quote, for inner block you should use single quotes here. Okay, so here I have done that thing. Then after that I'll print row, then pop tr tag, and inside this I'll print my table columns. So I'll write first id. Okay, so I'll copy and paste this thing here, id, then username, then I'll print password, then I'll print first name, then I'll print last name. Okay, so same thing you can do for other values. Okay, just for your understanding I will limit up to last name only. So I'll give semicolon here. Now I'll go for next loop, that is while loop I will use here. So why to use while loop? Because we are having, sometimes it may happen that we will have multiple rows. Okay, so that time the while loop is used. Okay, but now we are having only one row, but just for your understanding we'll use here while row, while block. So in while block we'll use condition, that is dollar row is equal to mysqli underscore fetch underscore ASSOC. So here I am converting my data, the whole string, into associative array. So whatever string written by the database, okay, the query, the output whatever written by the query, that I'm going to convert into associative array with the help of this function, that is mysqli underscore fetch underscore assoc. So here I will pass again this result variable because that is having the response of the query. Then in this block I will print, I'll print my table rows now. Okay, so here I will print my table rows or table row, and in that table row I will print columns. Okay, so I'll write here these things. Okay, so for first tr and td tag I will enclose within double quote, and then I will give a dot operator that is called as concatenation operator in PHP. So here I will concatenate this dollar row. So now dollar row, this is this will be one of the array. So this will be the associative array. So you know that in associative array the index will be the names. Okay, so here index will be your column name. Now so I'll use column name first, id. Okay, so the same code I will copy now, which will be helpful for us for next. Okay, so I'll copy this and I'll paste it here. Okay, now you can see here. Okay, so here now you can see again I have I'll print a username here. Now after this and next thing, okay, that is password. Password column value I will print here. The next value I will print now, that is first name. Now the next value I will print here, that is last name. Okay, so here we have done everything. Now after this we'll close our table tag with help of echo again. So I'll write table tag. I will close table tag because we open our table tag outside this while loop. Now after this I will put one else block. I'll put one else block which will print. Okay, I'll write here else. So I'm having this if here. So for this, if this condition goes false, there are zero rows, zero number of rows, it will display echo, it will display zero results. Okay, this statement it will display there. Okay, so this way we have defined our getData.php file. We have accessed our data from the previous page. The previous page has sent the data to the getData.php now. And in getData.php you handle that input, and now we have generated our response. So now we'll go to logout.php file. Here the logout.php file is defined. It's very easy to define logout.php. So just write your php tag. Now here first the most important thing, that is you have to start your session first. We'll start session underscore start, call this function, then call session underscore unset. So this will remove the session. Okay, this will disconnect the session and this will stop the session. And after that we have to use session underscore destroy. So this will destroy or this will delete all the variable session variables or their values. And then we'll transfer the control to again your location, that is login.php. So after logout we'll again return back to the login.php now and then type exit. Okay, so this is about your logout.php file where we have done the session management. We have destroyed the session and we are returning back to the login.php. Now we'll run this code. Okay, we'll go to the browser and here I'll type localhost and my URL, that is practical. Okay, so here I am having login.php file. So here I'll type my username and password. So this is my username and password. Now I'll select the username, that is I have choose my name. So this first student name I have choose, that is Santosh. So it is showing this data which is stored in the database. Now you can see that the URL has not been changed here. The URL is same, that is welcome.php. just what has happened here. So again, see the change. I choose next name. Now the page is not refreshing here. Just this data is transferred to the next page with the help of AJAX code, with the help of JavaScript code. We are contacting with the next file, that is getdata.php. There we are handling the input and we are returning the result from the database. So this way you can use your AJAX in your PHP application. So now we'll click on logout button. So we'll check. Okay, we'll see third student name. Okay, so it is showing the result here. Okay, and then logout button. Okay, now it is returning back to the login.php. just see whether our page is secure or not. So if I go for welcome.php directly, what is happening? It is returning back to the student login form. So here we have done the session management. Because of session management, we can make our pages secure. Now every page cannot be accessed without logging into the account. So this is about your assignment number 4, there where we have implemented student the student registration system, in which that we have developed in PHP, and then with the help of AJAX we have done the asynchronous operations. So if you have any doubt, if you have any suggestions, please post in the comment box. So do share my video, like my video, and subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe my channel for getting the upcoming videos. So thank you for watching my video. Bye bye.